Welcome back from that short break, and you are still watching news here on UBC TV. My name is Edward Rukidi Kijenangoma, and Mugalu Mohammed is on sign language. At the beginning of this show, we told you that we'd be joined by the Archbishop Stanely Ntagali, and to discuss or talk about the forthcoming Janan Luwum Day that will be celebrated in Kitgum District on Saturday, the 16th of February. And I'm privileged to be in the studio with the Archbishop himself. And Archbishop, a very good evening to you, and welcome to this show.
Good evening to you, and thank you for inviting me. I'm delighted to be here.
We are also very delighted to have you here.
And
thank you very we much. Know it's been a very, very busy day for you.
Oh, yes,
you know,
it
right
has.
From the morning,
yes,
you know, yes. Being at Parliament, and also, you know, at the cathedral to
yes,
pray for,
yes.
for the soul of the late Cyprian.
That's right.
Yes, and but let's look at the forthcoming Janan Luwum Day in Kitgum. Tell us, what are the preparations so far, and where exactly will it be taking place?
Yes, dear viewers, and all of you, thank you for that question. 42 years ago, the third Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, Rwanda, Burundi, and Boga Zaire, Janan Luwum, was martyred by Idi Amin. He was the second African bishop, but the third, because the first one was CMS, Leslie Brown, and then Eric Sabiti was the second archbishop, but first Ugandan or African archbishop, and then Janan Luwum was the third. During that time, Archbishop Janan Luwum was very honest, leading the flock. They were with his fellow bishops, they were together, and then the circumstances of that time, he was always honest and speaking the truth, challenging the government of the time, and he was victimized and then martyred. He was killed by Idi Amin on 16th of February 1977. And because of his position, of his truthfulness, he was murdered and martyred. And later, he became the martyr of the 20th century.
Yes.
So we have, as a province, continue to honor him. As I have said, he was the Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, Rwanda, Burundi, and Boga Zaire, and those later got independence. Those are the provinces in our neighboring countries and provinces. But since then, we have prepared to always honor him, commemorate him, and it started in my time. I'm very humbled that 2014, I started organizing commemoration of the martyr of the 20th century, the third Archbishop of Uganda, and I went to Mucheweni personally, presided over the service, and then we continued up to this day. So now we have a local committee within Kitgum, and we have a national committee and a provincial committee, but they are working together, and we want to thank all those who have been involved. The arrangements are ready now. Pilgrims have already moved to Kitgum, some on foot, especially from Gulu. They walked on foot up to Kitgum Mucheweni, where the late Archbishop was buried. And there has been a mission within the Diocese of Kitgum. I want to thank Bishop Wilson Kitara and the clergy and Christians of Kitgum Diocese. So on Saturday, all roads will be leading to Mucheweni in Kitgum Diocese. And I will be there, as usual, to preside over the commemoration service, 42nd commemoration service of Janan Luwum, the martyr of the 20th century.
Thank you so much, Archbishop. Of course, that is the program for Saturday. But let's look at the man himself. Who was Janan Luwum as a person?
Janan Luwum was a pastor. He was a humble man. He was a teacher. He was a counselor, a mentor. And he stood for the truth of the gospel. And he loved justice, he loved peace, he loved the gospel of the kingdom of God. So he was exemplary in his time, and that is why we remember him, that he stood firm and he didn't want. You know, at one time, people said, why can't you go out in exile? He said, I can't leave my flock. He was offered many opportunities, but because he was humble and he loved Jesus and the flock that had been entrusted to him, mm-hmm. he didn't want to go into exile. He remained until his death.
Mm-hmm. Because, Archbishop, I would imagine during that time, you know, killing or murdering an archbishop, and not just an archbishop of just Uganda, but the entire region, you know, Rwanda, Mboka Zaire, Burundi. I mean, during that time, I just imagine that Christians or the church was being, there was persecution, and I don't know how did it impact on the church.
Yes, you are right. Like every Ugandan was persecuted, there was fear, and everyone used to live under fear. But I want to tell you that Christians, believers, drew closer to God. Mm-hmm. And even after the martyrdom of Janan Luwum, people continued to pray, and that even brought the downfall of the dictator of the time. So mm-hmm. people were looking to God. There was no other solution, and people were committing themselves to God, and God answered the prayers of Ugandans and Christians all over the world and other people who love peace and justice.
Mm-hmm. So we expect, because the late Archbishop, of course, was the Archbishop of this region, do we expect some visitors from neighboring countries to
yes,
be flocking to Gulu?
It is well known all over the world. 16th of February, even Church of England and all the Christians all over the world. So we expect pilgrims to come from all over, those who can, to join us at the commemoration on Saturday in Michuini.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's talk about the day itself. Previously, it wasn't a day that was being celebrated or marked as a public holiday, but recently government decided to make it a public holiday. Why did it take so long?
Yes, that's a very good question. I'm humbled, mm-hmm. as I told you, that it was after 1 year in office as the Archbishop of Uganda, the 8th Archbishop of mm-hmm. Uganda, mm-hmm. that I felt inspired by God to begin presiding over the commemoration, provincial mm-hmm. commemoration. And 2015, I invited His Excellency the President, and he came with Mama. They put a wreath on the grave in Michuini, and that was his first time. His Excellency came for the first time. Mm. And when the service ended, I was giving my remarks, and I requested him to make it a public holiday, and His Excellency accepted, and it was taken to Parliament, debated, unanimously passed, mm-hmm. and gazetted. I want to thank the Parliament of Uganda and the President of Uganda for allowing February 16th to be a public holiday. So, and the international media, you may want to know, when that happened, they mm-hmm. said the forgotten matter celebrated. That
wow.
was, and indeed it was quiet, there were no celebrations, but now it has picked up and everyone wants to go to Michuini. Mm-hmm. My brother bishops, I want to thank them mm-hmm. because they always join me. And I appeal to those who don't come to Michuini to celebrate the matter, Janan Luwum, in your own churches, congregations, dioceses, so that we all feel that we are inspired by the great man of God.
Mm. I know, Archbishop, you're very tired, but when you start speaking, everybody out there would like to keep watching you and listening to you.
Thank you.
But just briefly, let's talk about today's events. Of course, the church has also lost another big person,
that is the late
Bishop Cyprian Bamose. He was the first bishop of Busoga Diocese.
Correct.
It's a big loss to the church,
indeed,
but also the Busoga region.
That's right. Mm. Today I presided over the funeral service at St. Paul's Cathedral, Namirembe. Most of the bishops came. Our host, the Bishop of Namirembe, Wilberforce Kitu, where I was there, and his wife, and many bishops mm-hmm. were there. The Bishop of Busoga, Bishop Paul Neimane, the Bishop of Bukedi, Central Busoga, they were all there, and the retired bishops who worked with him, mm-hmm. like Bishop Muntebi, the retired Bishop of Mitiana, mm-hmm. and their wives. So we had a big celebration. The deputy speaker was there, and many dignitaries, ministers, judges. The cathedral was full, mm. and we were thanking God, celebrating the life of Bishop Cyprian Bamose, the first bishop of Busoga Diocese. He served mm. as a bishop for 26 years,
wow.
and he founded Busoga Diocese and mentored many clergy, including those who are bishops today.
Mm-hmm.
He was a great man. And we were thanking God for his life. He gave him to us as a gift, and he mentored many clergy. And Busoga Diocese, you'll be happy to know, that it has given birth to Central Busoga Diocese. Mm-hmm. And I mentioned in the church today mm-hmm. that the 24th Provincial Assembly in August last year granted the status of a diocese mm-hmm. Which was requested by Busoga Diocese of East Busoga, that is Iganga, Bugiri area. Bugiri mm-hmm. area will be another diocese carved out of Busoga mm-hmm. Diocese. So Bishop Bomoze was a principled man, and we were praising God because he did a lot of development in mm-hmm. his diocese. Mm-hmm. So we honor God, we praise God for Bishop Bomoze, and he has left a legacy that will always be remembered. So we want to thank God. And now the program will continue. And finally, he will be laid to rest mm-hmm. on Sunday at Christ Cathedral Bugembe in Busoga Diocese. There okay. will be a big service at his burial, mm-hmm. and I hope to be there mm-hmm. With my brother bishops and all the clergy and Christians mm-hmm. and political leaders. We want to be there and continue to thank God as we send him off.
Okay. Finally, Archbishop, just briefly, maybe in 1 minute. It is, to me, I see it as a milestone, in the church history. The church house. Finally, we have it. It's up and running. And that is something that I remember when I was growing up, I used to hear about the project, the church house project. But today it is up and running. This is something that most people actually, especially the Christians, those who are the Anglican, are Christians, to have something, a project of that magnitude. Because formerly they say, the Anglicans, they are not into business, but today it is something different.
Yes, thank you. That has changed. Because our God is a God of business, and he gave us the mandate to exploit the creation positively as stewards. Mm-hmm. So church house is something that makes every Christian in Uganda and all friends of the church very happy. Mm-hmm. When you are on Kampala Road opposite Bank of Uganda, that 16-storied building, I feel humbled that it has been finished in my time.
Yes.
God's time is the best. Mm-hmm. It has taken us so long, but we are stewards and we thank God. I want to thank all the bishops, all the clergy, all the Christians who contributed generously towards the completion of Church House, and our partners, the Equity Bank, that is a great partner in development, that loaned us the money that helped us, on top of the shares that we are getting from dioceses, we have been able to complete it. And Equity Bank is our anchor tenant, because they have taken about four floors or five, and they are continuing, and now Equity Bank has moved from Katwe to Church House, and the branch of Church House is called Equity Bank Church House Branch. And we want to thank God for that partnership and all the Christians who have prayed for us. It took us long, but God's time is the best time. So we thank God. And now as Church of Uganda, we look at investment, because our God is a God of investment. We want to work hard, have money generating projects all over the province, in our parishes, in our dioceses, and in the province, because the money in the offertory bag is not enough, but God owns all the money.
Yes.
Silver and gold belong to him.
Yes.
Cows on a thousand hills belong to God.
Yes.
So we want to thank God for Church House and many other projects. Like All Saints Cathedral, we are roofing a cathedral that will host 5,000 people. And when you move around the province, there is a lot of construction going on, church buildings,
yes,
clergy houses. We want to invest for God and for his own glory as good stewards of what God has given us.
Your final word to the viewer and the Christians in this country.
Dear viewers, I want to thank God for this time, and I want to pray that God will bless you. We want always to be good stewards, faithful, as we look at Janan Luwum, the matter of the 20th century. I want to invite all of you to join me in Mutwini on Saturday. And if you are not coming, please continue to pray for the church. And we thank God for Mama Mary Luwum, who always comes, and the children and the grandchildren, because we feel all of us inspired by the life and ministry of Archbishop Janan Luwum. Thank you for praying for us, and continue to pray for us as we emulate the example of Archbishop Janan Luwum.
Thank you so much, Archbishop. It's been a pleasure having you here.
Thank you.
And we do hope that you'll be coming back some other time
yes.
when we need to see
thank you. Very
and
much.
Also journey masses
thank you.
As you travel to Kitgum and also to Busoga for burial of the late Bishop Cyprian Bamoze. That has been Archbishop Stanely Ntagali, and we've been discussing the forthcoming Janan Luwum Day that will be held in Kitgum on the 16th. That is on the 16th of February. That will be on Saturday. But also the burial of the late Bishop of Busoga Diocese, that is Cyprian, who died recently, and the burial will be on Sunday. Thank you so much for this, and we'll take yet another short break, but News Tonight continues after that. Stay with us.